All right, hello everybody, and welcome back to our retro Star Wars streaming series. My name is Nick Langer, the editor-in-chief of The Scapist, joined by Marty Sleva, and today we should be wrapping up Jedi Knight, Jedi Academy, if I don't get lost in a level.
I thought you said there was two more left, didn't you?
I don't know. We'll see how fast I finish.
Bump up on them all. Hello everyone, welcome everyone to chat. Nick, I'm glad to see that you've updated the goal at the top right of the screen like you said you would 2 days ago.
Not my fault. I'm waiting for Jesse and Amy to confirm the thing that we want to do.
Jesse and Amy. That's their synergy name. Jamie.
What is this?
Hello, welcome everyone to chat. Welcome George Lucas. Hello everyone in YouTube. What's up, Gelden, Old Hunter, Andrew, Timenwig. Your name is harder to say. James Conn, what's up, everybody? Welcome. As you can see, we are going to have a new funding goal at the top, but all the money that is over the 100% mark is going to go towards that funding goal. So don't worry. We're not putting in a slush fund or anything. We don't do slush funds. And of course, I'm sure you guys know if you've been watching streams lately, but we hit two milestones on Patreon. We hit 700. Which means Nick is planning a reunion with his waifu, a full-day Persona stream, which will probably be an early Saturday in February. And then we hit 750, which means Darren Mooney, film critic extraordinaire, is going to be playing video games like the rest of us heathens. He's got a PS5. He's going to be playing The Last of Us. He's playing a little bit of Miles Morales. He's got some immortality up in him. He's going to cover it. We're going to figure out how that's going to look. He's going to cover it. It's going to be great. An Imperial Dreadnought.
I'm gonna get us out of here. And somebody else, where I got lost last time. I did not get lost. We are starting right where I left off on this mission. I can't break free. Okay,
here's the plan. I served on one of the ships back in my Imperial days. Four went live. I was gonna tell a story of the preview event I went to in my career that ended up having the most unexpected and lavish thing attached to it.
Oh yeah.
And it was the year 2012, I believe. Maybe 2011, maybe 2012. And it was a preview for Epic Mickey 2.
Mm-hmm.
They flew me down to Anaheim. I got to play about 30 minutes of the game, which is not a lot for a flight to Anaheim. And then they rented out Disneyland for like 100 people. And so we had free reign of Disneyland for an entire night. And they made us reservations. Apparently Disneyland has some like secret restaurant that's impossible to, like, you can't make regular reservations at. You need to, like, I don't know somebody or something, or like exhume the bones of Walt Disney. And they made us reservations there. And so we got to eat at the secret Disney restaurant. We got to wander around Walt Disney's apartment, which is like in like old Main Street Disney. So it was very, very exciting. Yes, Gelden did get to meet Warren Spector. He seemed very, very nice. That was the second most other stuff compared to actual getting to play a game for a preview. The worst was going to all the way to Paris for Assassin's Creed Unity.
Yeah.
And the game was not played.
That's
the game was not hands-on.
Cool. What English you got?
Counterpoint.
To go to Paris.
Counterpoint. Got to go through the catacombs. That was cool.
Yeah.
Lampy Club 33. That was the name of the Disney. It's invite-only membership and costs a lot to join. Or all you gotta do is preview Epic Mickey 2, which, let me tell you, it's not a great game. I was not fond of it in my preview. Yeah, Old Hunter, welcome back to Tip Jar. Thank you so much, Old Hunter.
Yeah, we were talking about that because I have a press junket coming up where they're doing something for, but I'm not gonna do it just because, I don't know, I don't... At least for game previews, I try to stay away from doing that kind of stuff because I don't want to be accused of, you know, who you got bought, you know, whatever. But I will say, like, on the...
I'm going to take one. Anyone wants to buy me off.
Yeah.
I'll send you my Venmo if you want to buy me off.
Yeah, I think, like, at least with our community, like, people know, like, you know, we're not going to be swayed by stuff like that, I think, for the most part. But, like, when we do the documentaries, like, those are my favorite trips to do because, like, you know... To do the documentaries, like, you kind of have to break the ice with people a little bit because, like, you're having really long and detailed and intimate conversations about stuff. Mm-hmm. So, you know, a lot of times, like, we'll go out for, like, a nice dinner with the team or, like, go to a bar, kind of hang out for a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, just good times. The Iceland one was awesome. Like, we got to go to We went to Blue Lagoon with the development team. So just, you know, setting hot spring and some beers at the scene. And
I love that.
Stuff like that. All, you know, those are the kinds of trips I'll remember for the rest of my life, kind of thing.
Oh, absolutely. Speaking of that, I heard Epic Mickey was really good. Didn't it bomb really badly, though? Yeah, it was a very expensive game. I liked the first one more than the second one. Epic Mickey 2 originally was supposed to be a musical, like a game that was a musical, which I think would have been really neat because we don't really have that a lot. I think that would have been like an interesting, I don't know, something different, like forging a new path. But what it ended up being was kind of like a weirdly grimdark action platform. But it did bring Oswald the Rabbit back to the spot. Let me tell you, shout out to Oswald the Rabbit. Top 10 rabbit. Andrew Hickabottom said, Nick, shit. Did you have tears in your eyes when you wrote that Halo piece for the site recently? Yeah, it was the Wesley Snipes image of him like crying and holding the gun, getting ready to kill Tony Hawk in the race war.
No, I'm just super frustrated that like Halo isn't where it should be, especially at this new age of Microsoft, and like, it, I don't know, it just makes me concerned about Microsoft in general that like they can't get their biggest IP right. And I know, like, you know, I feel like a lot of people have maybe soured quite a bit on Phil Spencer just because, like, he's a lot of talk and just hasn't done a lot of showing yet. That's kind of how I'm starting to feel about it. But
also,
yeah,
it's definitely not their biggest IP anymore.
What is?
Elder Scrolls?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, when it comes out.
I don't know, like, if we're talking about games of their back catalog, like Skyrim's their biggest game ever, right? Minesweeper.
Well, yeah,
and
but
if,
I mean,
and if the Activision thing goes through, like,
as far as like the Xbox brand, Microsoft or Halo is still, I think they're.
It's yesterday. I think Halo's time has passed.
I
think Halo peaked over a decade ago.
Yeah, I don't know. To me, Halo's like, if they get it right, it'll be huge. They just haven't got it right in a long time.
But we're at that, God, what example? It's almost like The Simpsons. We're at a point where it's like there's been more bad Simpsons than good Simpsons. Like, there's been more forgettable Halo than there's been
Halo. That's not true.
The last three Halo games.
people like Halo 4. It was
no one talks about Halo 4.
The Halo community
I don't think it has a step run. Halo community. Community of everything.
It got ruined. Yeah, it got ruined in retrospect because of Halo 5. But Halo 4 is quite good.
I'm Rao. Thank you so much. So is it worth hopping over to Patreon or to continue on Escapist Plus? Patreon is where we're going to be firing on all cylinders.
Escapist. You mean Pico on the website? Yeah, it switched over to Patreon. We're getting ready. We're not like leaving the website behind on that stuff. We're just getting ready to probably move off of the system that we're using there and get everything in one place on Patreon for the website.
There you go. Lampy with a highlight message said Halo's been dead for years, but to keep beating its corpse, Destiny took the crown from Halo.
It really just didn't. Like, I know they're just very different games. Destiny is like,
one's good and the other one's not.
Yeah, I mean, Destiny doesn't have like the big bombastic single player campaigns that Halo was known for.
Past. Things change. I think this might be the first thing you've loved that's breaking your heart because things can't last. There's very few franchises that can maintain being at the top of the mountain throughout the decade.
Well, I don't even want Halo to be at the top of the mountain. I just want them to take it seriously. It's just frustrating. Like, Infinite is just frustrating because like the bones of everything that I want is right there, and I don't know why they can't capitalize on it. And like, why create a team like 343, staff it full of contractors, and then just let it fall apart like that? It just doesn't make sense.
Yeah, there's a lot of interesting tweets from former.
And like they're all yelling at management, and I've never wanted to be that person to like, you know, say like, oh, you know, it's all Bonnie Ross's fault or anything, but like, they should have had management changes after the mess that was Halo 5. And also, like, I, you know, gonna sound toxic for a second, but looking at the Halo show,
whatever, if you're about to say something, don't
if you're about to sound toxic
don't say whatever you're about to say.
I'm just saying, looking at the Halo show, like, you can tell that it just, they don't know what they want to do with it. And I don't think
the show's not very good.
Yeah, and like Kiki Wolfhill is in charge of the show. And she's, you know, from 343
she's
directly.
She's not in charge. She's not the showrunner.
She's not the showrunner, but like, that was her baby.
Oh, yeah.
And she's still in the leadership position on it. And I don't know why, when it's clear that, you know, her and Bonnie Ross and whoever else was at the charge of Halo just didn't get it.
Yeah, that show's kind of a dud. I hope it picks up in the second season. We'll see.
Yeah.
There's some examples of writing a sinking ship, but...
Yeah, I mean, the bones are there for it to be good. It's just, you know, they. What's the point of like writing all these books and everything that are tying into Infinite and Halo Store and expanding the lore if you're not going to do anything with it? It's just books.
And franchise has those like random ass books, though.
Well, I understand that, but I mean, like, it's good. That stuff is good.
Yeah.
So I just like I it's. It's like a trend in media right now to not take what's working and go with it, and instead it's like, no, yeah, we have to be creative and do our own thing. It's like, no, that's not what fans want.
Yeah.
And The Last of Us show's proving that. Like, if they change that, the outcry would be crazy from fans.
Stay tuned.
Yeah, I as much as we've like talked about
tractor beam disabled.
You know, source material not being the end-all, be-all. The more of these things that come out, I'm erring on the side of, like, I think there's a difference of being directly tied to the source material and also, like, really just respecting the source material.
Yeah.
And not, you know, I don't think you need to make your own mark on the thing. Just, yeah. Yeah, I don't know.
I disagree with you in the fact that I think Halo, you can't, like, Halo games aren't games you could just easily, you know, quote-unquote, easily adapt.
No, and I still don't agree with that. I just think there is enough material out there that they could pull from books and stuff like that.
I mean,
that
maybe at a certain point, if you start pulling from books, you start owing those people royalties.
Like, good.
And they're like, well, we don't Eric
Nyland deserves it.
I wish, you know, these MCU movies that are clearly pulling from characters and character arcs and events created by writers and artists who aren't seeing shit from it. You know, I think that's a bummer.
Mm-hmm.
Andrew Hickenbottom with a £2 donation, excuse me, Andrew, thank you so much. Said they should make Nick the CEO of Halo. I think that'd be great. So, and then we have, when I was talking about how there's very few franchises that have been able to withstand the decades, we have conflicting opinions on something. Hobo Joe says Assassin's Creed, another franchise that went on way longer than it should have, whereas Old Hunter says it's funny, everyone picks on Assassin's Creed, but still financially successful and has some popularity. I think Assassin's Creed is absolutely an example of a franchise that has managed to withstand the test of time, whether you like the direction it's gone in or not. Like, those games are still extremely popular, they sell extremely well, they generally review really well.
Assassin's Creed to me is just a brand name at this point. Like, there's no connecting thread anymore, because nobody gives a shit about the Templar versus Assassin's story that it was built on.
But that's what you don't give a shit about.
Nobody gives a shit about that.
The thing is, you're not a fan of it, so you don't care about it, and that's the way I feel about Halo's story. Like, you need to the time Luigi died in Nintendo Direct, you need to remove your soul from your body and look at Halo from another perspective. Like, unless you're a hardcore fan of the thing, like, there's not a lot in Halo that, like, feels new or feels different or feels unique. Just kind of Star Wars-y and Starship Troopers-y, and I don't know.
Halo has more of a identity than Assassin's Creed. Assassin's Creed is just open world.
I completely disagree with
how?
You.
Oh, Assassin's Creed is just open world historical RPGs. That's all they are now.
Halo's just a shooter!
With a connecting storyline and a base character. Assassin's Creed could be any location, any time, and it's just a brand name.
That's part of the... Well, but, like, you're talking about, like, Halo. Like, there's been this, like, Bible that they've been following the whole time. But like, they really haven't. It's been these like disparate campaigns, and some of them have been really good, and some of them have kind of fallen flat on their ass. And then most people's memory of these games are multiplayer, which like is a completely, you know, different component than the campaign.
Yeah, but like, Halo still has an identity to it. When you think of Assassin's Creed, what do you even think of anymore? What would you even say?
Like, historical adventure. Adventure of the week. Yeah.
It used to be, when you go back to the Ezio trilogy and everything, there was like a running storyline through them. Now nobody cares about
that. The problem is running storylines, by and large, are a bad idea in my mind. Like, forcing the audience to kind of buy into like 20 years of lore is the easiest way you get people to roll their eyes and be like, I don't fucking want to do this bullshit. And so I think Assassin's Creed's way of doing it is pretty smart, honestly, of being like, a bunch of people are going to see the Assassin's Creed set in feudal Japan come out and be like, oh, hell yeah, I just want this feudal Japanese thing. And maybe there's like a little sprinkling of,
But they're not buying it because it's Assassin's Creed. They're buying it because it's an historical RPG in Japan.
No, but they're buying it because Assassin's Creed is a known brand, is because you kind of understand what is going on there. Like, you get, like, Assassin's Creed, like, it has a base level, and it has had a base level, I think, since Assassin's Creed 2, at the very least, that, like, you kind of know what you're going to get there. Whereas with Halo, like, you don't really know what you're going to get. Sometimes you get a cool campaign, sometimes you get a game that fucks up its multiplayer, sometimes you get a game that promises it's going to live forever, but doesn't. I'm not even that big of an Assassin's Creed fan. I don't know where that came from. I don't know why.
I agree with that. Assassin's Creed as a brand means pretty much nothing to me anymore. I see a cool location that I want to play in, and I know I'm going
to
get a
historical
RPG.
What does Halo mean to most people? Like, I don't think Halo means shit to most people. Halo's like, oh, there's like there's a big armor boy. I could be the big armor boy.
Yeah. I don't agree.
I think you're lost in the Halo sauce. I think you got too much Master Chief dip on your chip. That's what I think.
In what way? I'm not saying it's the biggest franchise in the world. Aside from Gears of War, I think it's the only iconic IP that Microsoft has anymore.
They bought Skyrim. It's Skyrim and Fallout. Those are huge.
Yes, but they're not like tied to the
Doom.
They're not. Marty, I understand that, but they're not like Xbox brands like Halo was. People bought Xbox for Halo. They will, they will for Skyrim and Elder Scrolls now. This is stupid. I don't have the weapon to take these guys on.
I mean, people bought an Xbox and a 360 for Halo. I don't know if anyone bought an Xbox One or a Series X for Halo at this point. Like, I don't know. I just think it's I think there's a difference between the first half of Halo's history and the second half of Halo's history. I don't disagree. Like, Halo 1, 2, and 3, I think, have a massive cultural footprint. I think those were defining.
Yeah, no, Halo definitely does not have the footprint that it used to have, and they've been trying to recapture that. I'm not gonna argue about that.
Yeah.
I just think, like, it's... It's almost like if Sony, I don't know, what would even Sony's flagship brand be now? Uncharted, The Last of Us? Do they have
Spider-Man,
one?
God of War, Tsushima.
The one...
Horizon. But I mean, if you put all your eggs in one basket...
I know not putting your eggs all in one basket. I'm just saying, like, Xbox hasn't evolved past Halo yet. That's the problem.
Need to evolve when you could buy. Honestly.
They have bought, and our entire argument is that they haven't done anything with those investments yet. That's every time we talk about that. That's what Casey.
It'll happen. What do you think? If I had to put a gun to your head, what is Nintendo's flagship IP?
Mario.
Okay. Just Mario? The Greater Mario Universe? Does Mario Kart count in that? Considering it's like an all-time selling game now?
I mean, Zelda's obviously, you know, up there, but I think, like, when people think, the average person thinks of Nintendo, they think of Mario first and foremost.
Like, I mean, are you talking about, like, Mario, just Mario platformer?
Just the character and the IP, I guess.
Yeah. I think the thing Nintendo has is Mario is, like, monolithic. Mario is Mickey Mouse. Mario is a vessel for whatever container you want Mario to fill, and so whether that's Kart or Smash.
Mm-hmm.
Or a movie or a theme park. And then they have Zelda for the weirdos like me, and then they have and then they have Pokemon, which obviously isn't their theirs, but yeah, is you know, a massive thing. So
okay, so okay, I don't know. I don't know. Well, yeah, I did a quick save and then now I don't have the security key, and you get it from the guy that died in here. So I was just on his body. So that's now his body disappeared. Okay, so I guess his body's security key. I have the key. I just I don't know why it wasn't picking it up earlier.
Did the security key disappear with the body as well?
Some ass in chat was like, just keep trying the same door, thinking it'll work. I was like, I thought I had the key the whole time.
I don't have to pay attention to them. That's fine. I'll go away. Lampy with a £2 donation said, hashtag stand with Marty, hashtag Marty is right, and then a bunch of other people in chat say Marty's not right.
Well, I mean, if you don't care about Halo, it's... I mean, that's fine. I still think it's just... It's one of those franchises that could have the cultural relevance if they got it right. And they just haven't. And it should have been taken off of 343 after Halo 5-ish. And I still think that's what's going to end up happening, is 343, with all these layoffs and everything, I think they're going to be relegated to a support studio in their own franchise, and it's going to be given to somebody else.
Yeah, I mean, Microsoft's definitely not lacking for studios that can make good shooters.
Yeah, and that's just my entire point is just I'm just concerned at like how Microsoft has handled Halo. And my article yesterday was like calling out that they haven't even mentioned it in their showcases or anything lately, and it's like that doesn't make sense. And to me, it's just like, okay, they know it failed, so we're gonna get rid of it now.
Von Oberstein says Halo is the new Sonic. I kind of love
Far
it.
From it.
I kind of love it because I feel like the Sonic cycle, we now have the Halo cycle. And we do the Halo cycle every time. Also, Halo Infinite has some Sonic Frontiers vibes, if I'm not mistaken. I think they got a little similar.
God damn, these things are so...
But again, maybe I'll fall in love with Halo the same way I just fell in love with Sonic. So, there you go.
Well, at least...
Cream yells force push.
I've been doing that. I'm trying to do that. Say what you will about, like, hit, you know, 343. At least they very much get the gameplay right. Whether you like, the new Halo or not... Like, the games are good, yeah, mechanically and technically and everything. They just, it's really just a story of 5 that they really fucked up.
Yeah.
Oh my god. This is driving me nuts. I'm talking and I'm not paying attention to the game as much.
Uh-oh, too much spoofing, too much goofing.
Okay, we're gonna get rid of those guys. So I can just worry about getting rid of these things and move on.
Move on with my life.
Yep.
Oh yeah, couldn't be everything fits if such a mission's super rough. That's a bummer.
Yeah, it's just a tight ass hallway trying to fight these things and I can't get away. There we go, I killed them.
Damn, a tight ass hallway. Someone mentioned, Old Hunter said, what's your most anticipated game of the year that is not a sequel? I have sequel fatigue. Damn. I just realized probably like my 10 most anticipated games are sequels. Sea of Stars. Maybe Sea of Stars on the indie front. The AAA front, everything's a sequel. Everything's a sequel.
Yeah.
I was gonna ask if Final Fantasy 16 counts as a sequel, and I think it does because it's 16.
Yeah. Starfield's definitely up there for me.
Yeah,
I just,
that feels almost like a sequel to me.
No, sequel to what? What the hell?
It's just Fallout. It's just Fallout. Space. if Starfield could be its own thing, Final Fantasy 16 should be able to be its own thing. Doesn't have anything to do with the previous 15. Yeah, it's crazy how many of the big AAA games though are known quantities somewhere, whether it's Final Fantasy. Either
who was
16
it?
Or 7 Remake or
some,
Diablo,
I forget.
King Fighter.
There was like an interview or something the other day that like everybody's just focused on the mega franchises now. I don't remember where that came from, but it's like, yeah, it's not far off. Like, everybody's just trying to milk their mega franchises until they're dry.
Yeah, I mean, that's the problem is, like, outside of certain outliers with game budgets bloating so heavily, Mega Franchise are the only kind of safe bet you can make. And they're not always a safe bet. Mm-hmm. Plenty of those huge franchises stumble and fall on their face. Jay, someone must have said Kareem is recommending a lot of
already
fighters.
I don't know, I already said it. Yep.
George looks like I've had a glimpse of Crisis Core and Zach's dumb voice reminded me of Raiden. Zach Fair has heavy Raiden vibes. I will agree with that.
Haha! I have their concussion rifle. Yeah,
Andrew Hickabot. I already did the without even seeing a chat, so you're welcome.
Yeah, I guess my final. We were just talking. A heated discussion? Yeah.
No, we were talking. Nick and I argue like that all the time.
No, yeah, I definitely
aware. I
definitely have like my love for the Halo franchise. I think it's just after like three games where they haven't hit the mark, it's just like frustrating.
Yeah,
definitely know how Sonic fans feel and all that. Like they just want their favorite franchise to be good again.
Yeah,
and like and that's just the annoying part about Halo Infinite is like. Like I said, everything's there for it to be good, and I just want them to get those story expansions out, and now they're, you know, now we're laying off a single-player team. Like, well, what the fuck what are we doing? And also, like, why aren't you saying anything? Like, all this negative press that you guys get, it could go away if you just said, hey, here's our roadmap for the next 3 years of Halo. And like I said in my piece yesterday, I just don't think Microsoft even knows what that is now.
Yeah, I think that's pretty spot on. Bullshit.
And it's just frustrating that they don't communicate that, look, we know Infinite did not meet your expectations. We're going back to the drawing board. We're going to get it right.
Yeah.
And if that's not the case, great. I just want to know that. And we kind of talked about in Breakout yesterday, like, with games as a service now, I feel like I'm always waiting for, the games that I want to be good to be good. And I'd rather them just tell me, like they did with Anthem, no, we're not going to continue with this. It's dead. Sorry. Go play something else. I think it's just the lack of communication that just really annoys me.
Sure.
Especially and that's where like the cultural footprint of Halo. Like there is a ton of people that still love Halo and want it to be good. The subreddit is like one of the most active game subreddits out there. So it's like I kind of mentioned it in my piece. Like, I feel like 343 and Microsoft feels like they have the goodwill of fans to go on, but they just don't. And they haven't. Yeah. They haven't since 2014.
Yeah. I mean, I think one of the other problems is I'm sure I brought this up on Breakout yesterday, but when Halo was at its peak, we're talking about Halo 3, there was a lot less kind of competition. Whereas now they are not only competing they're competing with everything. Like story-wise, they're competing with all these single-player open-world RPGs. Multiplayer-wise, they're competing with a shit ton of free games like Warzone and Fortnite and PUBG and Apex and like, man, it's just it's a different world. It's a different world than the 360 era.
Yeah, no, I mean, they definitely lost their light, their limelight.
Yeah,
and it's just. I think you're right about that. I think I just think Halo has the potential again to be that big IP for Xbox.
At a certain point, you feel like Sideshow Bob just continually stepping on rakes. At a certain point, am I just bringing this on myself if I keep thinking this?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, Andrew Hickabon brings up Star Wars. It's kind of like the same way for people. I mean, just kind of waiting.
Halo
for
needs
Star
an
Wars
Andor.
Halo needs an Andor. I think where they really went wrong was just trying to continue Master Chief's story. I think it should have just been done after 3.
Yeah.
And, because the whole plan was for the Reclaimer trilogy, and then 4 did its thing, which people liked, and then they didn't they just kind of reset everything and broke all the storyline in 5. And then they're like, oh, now we need a reboot of the series because people didn't like that.
Yeah.
Get back to my ship. Okay. So, and that's like all those problems stem from management about just not having a plan. Okay, the Star Wars treatment. Didn't have a plan.
Ghost, welcome to Early Access. Lampy with a 5-pound dono. Thank you so much. So just replace your Halo love with Persona love. Hmm. It's a healthy thing to do. Okay, listen. As world's number one Persona fan, this is also a scary place to be. Because who knows when we're going to see Persona 6? Who knows that? And all the people who made Persona 3, 4, and 5 what it is are now working on a new IP that we haven't seen a glimpse from in 4 years. So also things I'm worried about.
Dimitri says, I feel like I'm an alien. I actually really like Halo Infinite's fleshed out small-scale character-driven narrative as opposed to the focusing on super weapons and giant galaxy-spanning wars. No, I agree. Like, Amy and I have been playing Infinite, and I... Wow. That just broke every bone in my body falling on that. No, I agree. Like, I like Halo Infinite for what's there. It just didn't feel done. The campaign felt half-assed. Because I don't think it was done. So,
yeah.
And that's just why I'm frustrated. Like, I just, you know, it's almost like Battlefield, right? Like, you go from Battlefield 4 to, and everybody's like, we want this. And the devs are like, okay, here's this. And everybody's like, no, not that. And it's all broken and squandered. And then they get it right with Battlefield 1 again. People, like, you know, it was buggy at launch and everything. They got it right. People love Battlefield 1. Then they do Battlefield 5, break everything they had. And then they do 2042, and that's just been a complete mess. I've ignored all the preview requests they've been asking us to do for that, because, like, that game just pissed me off, and I don't want to deal with it.
Preview what? Is the game, like, already out? All the new shit?
They've had, like, a preview session for, like, every season that they're doing. So, like, they've invited me back to, like, check out the new seasons and stuff. And I'm
you
like...
You should take the preview and then ask if we can have Dead Space and Wild Hearts code.
Yeah, this was nice and all, but what about Dead Space?
Yeah, what about that? What's going on that Ishimura? Is everything all right up there?
God damn it. I keep going on this fucking elevator. I know.
David of the Port, been a member for 16 months over on Twitch. So not complaining, but your default 1440 resolution crashes my Amazon device every stream because it's not supported. I have to reboot and try to quickly change to 720 before it crashes.
Oh,
David,
there's my elevator. Jeez.
Sorry to hear that. We need to. You know what we should do? We should protest outside Bezos' house. Let's go to Washington. We'll pick it. And we'll get some chowder. We'll get some chowder afterwards from the market.
I think it was Jumbly Wumbly that said, like, what a stage of grief is Nick is at. This feels like an intervention.
this is absolutely, you're at it. You're definitely at one of the stages of grief. Right? Also, one of my favorite
franchises that I grew up with are kind of in shambles with Battlefield
also,
and Halo.
I didn't want to call you out on it when you said it, but Lampy with a high-end message said the Halo subreddit isn't even in the top 20. Kerbal Space Program has more active subreddit. Yeah, there's no way the Halo subreddit is super active.
I didn't have any anymore because they're just mad about everything all the time. It's really toxic, so I don't go there anymore.
I for one am shocked that Reddit is. Right? Yeah. Reddit is toxic. In much better news, someone earlier before we started hyperventilating about the things we like, mentioned Marty. They announced Dokapon Kingdom for the West, and I am well aware. Nick and I already talked about it. I'm going to be writing a thing about why Dokapon Kingdom fucking rules. If you guys don't know what Dokapon Kingdom is, we talked a little bit about it last night on Breakout, putting a little winky link. You know what? We should have some menus right here. It was a PS2 and a Wii game that is ostensibly a Mario Party-esque board game crossed with a 40-hour JRPG. And so there's four people, and they play little characters that can assume different sort of like roles in an RPG, to where you can be a mage, or you can be a thief, or you can be a paladin or a samurai. But it's a board game, and everyone's taking turns and going around a thing and getting into like little battles and stuff, and trying to complete missions and recruiting people to their parties. But imagine a Mario Party game that lasted 40 hours. and had RPG elements and ultimately had the sort of, like, if you feel like someone effed you over at the end of a 20-turn Mario Party game, imagine how you'd feel at the end of a 40-hour campaign. I'm very excited. It's coming to the West. And we will absolutely be doing game nights. This should be easy. We'll see who can make who cry. Also, Andrew Hickenbottom with a 2-pound dono. Thank you so much. Said poor Nick will be broken if Aragorn turns out bad.
Probably. Hey, you know what? You know what franchise I grew up with that they haven't? I don't think they've fucked up. Is Gears of War, because I love Gears 5.
Gears is great.
I trust the Coalition to do good things.
Yeah.
And I know Gears 5.
I liked every Gears game.
Yeah, I know Gears 5 is. Yeah, I know Gears 5 is divisive, but I love it.
I really like that campaign. I think that campaign's great.
Yeah, it reminded me so much. Like, it's the only game that has like successfully like redone like the early 2000s era of campaigns and got it right.
Hobo joke. Gears of War ended with 3. You're missing out if you're not playing 4 or 5.
4's campaign is a little lackluster, but 5 is so fucking good. Ooh, Boba Fett.
I thought 4 did a decent job of introducing the new crew. I definitely like 5 a lot more, but...
Yeah. Just walk away. I don't know. Like, I legit think, like, Kate is one of my favorite characters in Gears of War.
Right? Yeah. George Lucas, Gears Infinite has a nice ring to it. No, nothing is infinite anymore. We're not allowed to make anything infinite. Everything has to be finite. Everything has to end. Everything needs to die eventually.
Wait,
Everyone's very excited, apparently.
This isn't what happened to Boba Fett. He was eaten by a sand creature, and then...
Robert Fettuccine. You've arrived.
Where'd he go?
He needs to take off his armor and be a big naked baby in a packed tank like he was on the show.
My fancy PC. My PC's outdated now compared to what's out there.
My PC has so much dust on it.
You gotta get that cleaned.
PC's a few nerds. You know what doesn't have dust on it? My Switch. You know what does have? Persona 3 and Persona 4 on it. I also bought Fire Emblem, even though I don't want it. I didn't want it.
I knew you were gonna buy it.
All the reviews are like, hey, it's not the thing you like about Fire Emblem, and it's more the thing you only sort of enjoy.
It's got the Nintendo Red on it. Mine.
I gotta have my opinions. I'm in the take game. I gotta have my takes.
Oh, I didn't even know I was dying. I keep forgetting to look at my health. Lots of talking today, not lots of playing.
Old Hunter says, you know what you would die for, Marty? Sonic Infinite. Sonic Infinite just sounds like an endless runner. I don't want that.
That already exists.
I think there already was a Sonic Endless Runner. Yeah.
If there's a dumb IP, there's a dumb Endless Runner to go with it.
Yep. There's an Uncharted dumb Endless Runner.
Hey, this isn't realistic. You took one lightsaber hit from Luke in the movie and died. Now I have to, like, slice and dice you. Oh, I know the flamethrower.
I need to finish the Star Wars Demolition piece, too. God damn it. I'm adding everything to my list tomorrow. Tomorrow's the day no one bothered me because I'm writing.
I give you all the assignments tomorrow.
No one bother me!
I'm the captain now. All this. Go away, Bubba. Nobody wants to deal with you. Stop burning me. You're a baby. Your flamethrower should be catching your cape on fire. I know people yell at me because we were asked about anticipated games, but I'm very, very curious about Hogwarts Legacy.
Yeah, I guess that kind of counts as a sequel. I mean, it's not a sequel, but it's based on existing IP.
Yeah.
I have a feeling that game's gonna be fucking huge. I don't know if it's gonna be good, but I have a feeling.
Everything I've seen looks really good. I wasn't sold on the combat until they showed somebody that actually knew what they were doing.
Yeah.
But the whole school aspect just sounds really fun.
If you like schools and games, may I direct you to Persona 3, 4, and 5?
No.
Dundum. Absolutely dundum.
I was listening to a discussion on NoClip about Hogwarts Legacy, and they're just, everybody's like super, super curious about like how the press is gonna really cover that game.
Yeah.
It's just such a weird. But I don't know, I think about Hogwarts Legacy and then I think about Activision Blizzard stuff and I'm like, this is all getting confusing and why can't people just not be shitty?
Yeah, but man, J.K. Rowling fucking sucks.
Yeah, she does. She's just one of those people that's like, you know, just stop going on Twitter and stuff.
Also, get that hatred out of your heart.
That's what I mean. Like,
get
just,
it out of your heart or die.
Yeah, I don't understand. Like, I don't know how you, with so many like people that are part of that community that love her books, like why you would.
She probably got in like a skiing accident and went fucking, and her brain got rattled and she's went nuts.
Yeah.
It is insane. Anyone who has that much money and still goes on Twitter, like, what? You got brain worms. What is going on? Man. Oh my god, if I ever had that much money, holy shit. Be able to port. How many Star Wars games are we in so far? This is the fourth.
Yes,
we did Dark Forces, Jedi Knight, Jedi Outcast, Jedi Academy, and then afterwards we have Republic Commando on the docket. And Nick still hasn't figured out what his next thing is.
Yeah, I've been researching the Prince of Persia games. I was playing Prince of Persia 1 on the Steam Deck. Through the PlayStation 2 Plus, it's a little rough.
Uh-oh.
Well, just because
wait a couple years for that remake.
Oh god, I bet that's one of the games Ubisoft canceled. they canceled that Project Q game. I completely forgot that existed. That was another one of those free to play games that they were looking to do. It was supposed to be like an arena brawler.
Saw the art. And that wasn't even one of those things that, like, triggered something in my mind. I was like, God, this doesn't. This looks like every other thing I've ever seen. I don't know what this is.
Yeah. I can't wait for you to finish that article. And the developer was like, why are developers like Ubisoft chasing trends instead of setting them? Like, Jesus Christ. That
everything would be fixed.
Literally, yeah. Like, stop letting executives chase trends. Ow. Ow. Jeez, what the fuck? These tracking missiles, where'd this come from? Where'd you come from?
The Duke of Doom says, hey Nick, can y'all do a Fort of the Damned in Sea of Thieves today? I don't know what that's about, but sure. Was a Fort of the Damned not the fort thing we did?
No, we did not do a Fort of the Damned.
It seems like a fort full of ghosts, which I would
that
call
was,
a
that was just an out. I think that was just an outpost.
Okay, if you have a fortress and it's full of ghosts, that is a Fort of the Damned in my opinion.
Yeah, we'll need to like plan out a little bit more so we're not in such a scatterbrain state on this one.
What do you mean scatterbrain state? I thought we did fine.
Well, after we did the Tall Tale mission, everybody's like, no, we don't want to do more missions. I'm like, missions are how you get treasure. Like, actual treasure.
Oh, but we just need to sail around and find some fun. That's what we did at Pulsar.
Yeah, now you guys don't want to do the PvP stuff.
We can't. No, it's fine. We just need to sail around and find some fun. We don't need a laminated itinerary.
No, we don't need that. We just need to make sure we're on the same page of what we want to do.
We're going to sail around and have fun. We went to that fortress. We stole a bunch of gold. We went back. We tried to sell it. Those fools fucking murked us and sent us to the bottom of the sea. That was fine. That was great. I thought it was wonderful. Duke of Doom says, the Fort of the Damned is a fort you can only do after collecting all 5 lantern colors and then fighting a bunch of skellies. What is it? All 5 lantern? How the fuck do I get a lantern color? What is happening?
I don't even know what lantern colors are. Oh, goddamn it. Oh, goddamn it. Okay, it didn't kill me. She did a backflip instead of front flipping because I hit an object.
Matthew Atkins with a $5 donation. Thank you so much. Can we have a funding goal where Nick has to play the Kinect Star Wars dancing game while wearing cat ears? That'd probably be a pretty large funding goal.
Yeah, if you want to pay off my mortgage, I'll do that.
There it is. Easy peasy. Skeptical Wizard, have you been enjoying Sea of Thieves, Marty? I have. I enjoyed myself. Actually, I was also enjoying the linear mission as well. I thought like defending the ship went on too long, I like kind of wandering around.
That's the biggest problem with that game is like the bot, and I don't know if they fixed it. If anybody plays Sea of Thieves regularly, because like the Golden Shore is when you fight Briggsy or whatever at the end, and that fight takes for fucking ever. Yeah. It just doesn't die. That's why I haven't gone back to it, because I'm like, that shit's so frustrating. Like, you sit there and, like, unload on him with cannonballs for 30 minutes, and he dies, finally.
Oh, Duke of Doom. Oh, okay, this is a good thing. Duke of Doom says, with those five different colored lanterns, whenever you die, you can collect a special lantern color on the respawn ship from the center of the ship. So when we die and we go to that ghost ship, apparently we can collect a new lantern color from the center of the ship.
What the shit?
But yes, I really like, I think Sea of Thieves is very pretty. I just like its vibes. It has a nice sense of playfulness. And I like just wandering around and finding some fun to do. I think it's great. I'm also a big Rare fan. So
I'm leaving this like this for a second because it's funny.
Do
you see what's on screen, Marty?
I do not.
This is how I died. Go look at the screen real quick.
I'm looking at the screen. I'm still quite a bit behind.
Oh, well then live fast forward it.
No, I'm on fucking Twitch, Nick.
Twitch sucks.
Share your feed with me then, Nick.
No, this game will break my computer for some reason. Oh, hi, Boba.
I mean, I'll you're running through some hallways, though. Lampy, with the highlight message said, Nick, have you got to the Pirate VIP Club in your personal games of Sea of Thieves yet?
No, I have not played Sea of Thieves at all up until... I mean, I've played it before, but I haven't touched it because nobody will play it with me. Everybody complains that it's too slow and blah, blah, blah.
Maybe you need better friends.
My friends are the escapist crew.
I get
so annoyed playing that game sometimes because even Yatsu's bugging me because it's just constant complaining. I'm like, oh my god.
You try to be the boss too much in the game. You need to be the boss less.
I will be the drunkard from now on.
You need to be boss less. You also need less. That's a hard stream. There's a lot of crosstalk. There's a lot of people everyone's trying to spoof and goof. Everyone gets spoof and goof fever. I'm trying to read super chats, and people are talking over me, and I'm like, there's so many goddamn super chats to read. No one's getting put in the brig. Everything's going to be fine. We're gonna get our footing. This is just like the opening of a movie where the team comes together, and they don't know how to work together. Like, the first time the Avengers get together, and they all get their ass kicked. This is going to be fine. We're gonna learn. We're going to learn how to be a well-oiled crew. Old Hunter. Said, Marty, I really liked the stream you did with your mate showing off a Banjo-Kazooie level and just the idea of you guys highlighting interesting game elements. Any plans for more streams like that? Yeah, I would like that to become an ongoing thing where it is someone showing someone else a thing in a game they really like and just getting excited about it. And so it is someone just playing through a game they know like the back of their hand and showing things off. Like the idea I had for it was show and tell. And so she's playing through something you really like. And you know, look how cool this thing is. We did that for a Christmas level. I thought that was nice. Force power in the scepter for one purpose, to resurrect. Counterpoint, I also need to be on
the first mission is super on rails, so I get the group's annoyance. Yes, I did not know that. And everybody was yelling at me about it.
I thought the mission was fine. I don't know. I think everyone needs to just cool their jets. I think their jets are
no kidding.
Too hot. Not cool enough.
Not exactly a vacation. The Duke of Doom says, Nick, did you really go to the Shores of Gold? I did. It is a long quest line.
How fun is Sea of Thieves if you play it by yourself?
Not at all. I mean, you can't run a galleon by yourself. You'd have to take a sloop. So, I mean, like, you can just travel around, but, like, I don't think the game...
kind of built for that.
Yeah, it's much more fun with people when, like, just all the emergent stuff happens.
How did he get a message out?
I don't know. Because, like, the gunplay and the sword combat is the weakest part of that game, and I can't believe they haven't overhauled that.
It's pretty bad.
It's really bad.
Pretty bad.
What about Ragnos? We have to go to Korriban.
Well, if we're lucky, we'll catch up with everyone else before the fireworks start. If you don't want to help me...
No. I'm coming.
Like, yeah, I guess if you just want it for, like, the exploratory and, like, going for gold, like, you can probably do that for Sea of Thieves, but...
Pretty, it is a pretty world to just hang out in.
Yeah, it really is. Like, I mean, the locations are fun to explore and everything. I can't really say for sure, though, because I haven't played it enough to know, like, how deep some of those secrets go. Like, when we were doing our test stream and we found that thing underwater, like, that was the first time I'd ever seen anything like that in the game.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and I wasn't sure if it was, like, is there a certain amount of waves we should keep going to, like, is there a finish to this, or do we just run away?
Yeah. Shit. I brought my concussion rifle. I'm good. Tell you what, though, like, you know, with all these, like, emergent co-op games coming out lately, though, I can't believe a AAA dev has not taken a stab at, like, making a AAA Phasmophobia. That game would sell, like, hotcakes. More and more indie devs are kind of picking up on it, so we'll see. But it feels like a... you know, if there's one trend you want to chase, that might be it, because that game, like, if that game actually had, like, AAA level animation and stuff, oh boy.
Yeah, I get the, I bet something's in development. I bet,
Did she just say it's hot right here when there's lava everywhere?
Not wrong, it is hot.
I guess. Just like, no shit.
Chombly says, I demand more tabletop simulator, more. We have it in our, it's going to be in our rotation. Did you guys have a good time in tabletop simulator?
Wow. We did. It's just, it's kind of hard to play with, like, 8 people, you know, like, yeah. For a community night. If we just did it with the escapist crew, it's doable. But, yeah. I mean, like, a lot of games are, like, 4 players and that's it.
Yeah.
And, like,
yeah.
Like, Uno worked, but it took forever. And the people were like, oh, we want to play a new thing. I was like, well, there's trouble, but that's only 4 people. And then.
Yeah. Lampy with a 20-pound dono. Thank you so much, Lampy. Said, here's 20 pounds to put Yahtzee in the brig the first time he complains about something in Sea of Thieves. You know what? I'm fine with that.
He'll be in there the whole stream.
We can do that.
Yeah, I feel like
first class troubles key to success. We'll do more first class troubles.
Yeah, I feel like Sea of Thieves is just like one of those games. Like, you gotta give it some time to get into the flow of it. At least that was.
I liked it immediately.
Yeah, there's.
I think for
a lot of people, they will like it immediately. But I think for people that like need instant gratification, it's just a game that takes a minute to get into.
Honestly, coming off Pulsar, like, it is 10,000 times more interesting than Pulsar. Yeah. In my opinion.
Played another big chunk of Death Stranding last night. Don't push me off the ledge, you shit. Oh, hey, is this hot?
Is this hot?
I fell into the lava. I was kind of waiting for her to say this is hot. It turns out Death Stranding running at like 60 frames per second makes that game much more enjoyable. It just feels so much smoother to play, obviously.
It is. It's really pretty good.
But I also, you finished it. Does the game give you like a way to play music later on, like on your missions, or is it only when it decides that it lets you do that? It's like there's a radio in the place you hang out.
Yeah,
in.
Like you get like a portable like a Walkman or something where you can play songs. Yeah. No, I mean the musical moments I remember from the game are the ones that are
just
like
all scripted,
handcrafted in there. Yeah.
Yeah. How do you like the lava? Enjoy that. Here, you can have some lava too.
Chain Whip and says, at what point Death Stranding do you go, yeah, this is good? I said that right at the beginning. I'm a mark for that, though. I really like Kojima and Sad Boy Wandering, so those two things I love. Old Honor says, I don't believe anyone actually enjoys Death Stranding. I do. I promise. People do.
It's not for everyone. Yeah, it definitely isn't. I mean, I don't know, it's just the kind of game that I've been kind of feeling like playing, like just more meditative experience for a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But yeah, everybody I talk to that's really played is like, yeah, after 10 hours in chapter 2, it gets really good. I think the mindset that I finally got into was I read a Reddit post on it last night, and it was basically like, treat the first like two acts of the game as like the Great Plateau and Breath of the Wild.
Mm.
It's like all training you for like the big world-changing stuff that's gonna happen later on.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, all right, I can get behind that. But it's also a game that like I'm only gonna play like an hour or two of every night, so I don't get burnout on it.
Yeah. Man, I burned through that game so quickly. That was one of those games. Like, I think I finished it in 4 days. But too much. That was too much. That was probably too much.
Yeah.
David Port enjoyed Death Stranding. Hell yeah.
Ah. Look up. There's a hole in the ceiling. Whoops. Force charge. Come on, recharge faster. Yeah, unfortunately, like, I think Death Stranding's worst part is the combat, so... If you don't like the walking stuff, then you're definitely not gonna enjoy it at really the end of the game.
Yeah. Yeah, it's funny going from, because I think the combat in Phantom Pain is like so good and so versatile and has kind of so much room for improvisation, whereas like if you're getting into like hardcore combat and Death Stranding, I always felt like it was because I messed up.
Yeah. How do you think How do you think they're going to change for Death Stranding 2?
I mean, that's a great question. Like, my gut is making it more like Phantom Pain. Like, combat seems to be one of the areas that they probably are going to really focus on. Like, really lean heavily into making that. Because that seems like that was one of the primary criticisms of the first game. Also, like, why do I keep falling down this fucking hill? But I think that's kind of the game. You need to keep falling down the hill.
Yeah.
George Lucas says, I didn't know Death Stranding had combat. I thought you just delivered packages and avoided Dementors. Yeah, there's like human bases that you need to like sneak into and steal a bunch of stuff. And if it goes well, you can avoid the combat. If it goes poorly, you get into combat. And the combat's not very good. Chain Weapon. Yeah, there's a lot of rumors that Konami's going to be... showing off stuff this year for the Metal Gear Solid 25th anniversary, which I think would be great. Even some like hints of the voice actor voices Raiden was talking about stay tuned soon to hear something cool. So, and a lot of folks have been talking about, you know, Sony having a bunch of third party exclusive deals this year. So, given the big Silent Hill blowout last year, I could absolutely see a similar thing happen with Metal Gear.
Yeah. Alright, you know what? I'm just gonna push you. I'm gonna push you out of the sky. Come here. God. These things are so annoying.
Seriously.
You can't pull them to you, so you can't really stab them because they're just flying. He just moves around like a little mouse. God. Ow! Sniper up there. Go away. Did you play the Crisis Core remake yet?
No, I'm playing this year. I'm planning to do a full Final Fantasy VII replay of old Final Fantasy VII Crisis Core, Dirge of Cerberus, Advent Children, and then VII remake.
Yeah, after having played the remake of Final Fantasy VII not too long ago, Crisis Core does not feel great to play.
A little rough. Yeah, yeah.
Because like it's almost like it's set up the same way as a JRPG, and then the combat's real time.
Yeah.
So like you just run through like very, I mean I'm only on like the second mission, but you run through very barren locations and then combat just appears like every 10 seconds.
Yeah, it's built on the bones of a PSP game. Like they zhushed some things up, but they didn't fundamentally change it at all.
I feel like if they were gonna do that, like I don't know, it's just kind of weird to like give it the graphical update that Final Fantasy VII got in most ways, and then not update the game to be like a full remake. I don't know.
Yeah.
I didn't look at much of the coverage of it, so I didn't realize, like, I knew it wasn't like a full remake like VII was.
Yeah.
I just was expecting a bit more modernization than what's in there.
Yep. Duke of Doom with a Highlight Message. Marty, have you watched Uncle from Another World? I have not. It is on my list of anime I need to get to, which is terrifyingly long.
I can't reach you with the pole.
I finished a rewatch of the original Trigun series, finishing up Gundam, which is Mercury now, and then I've been watching the new Trigun and Nier, and I also want to get through Summertime Rendering. Kind of dropped on Hulu, the entire thing, so I want to check that out. It's apparently a little time loopy.
Oh god, there's another one.
And hell yeah, David, glad to hear that. Yeah, old ass JRPGs are great. Marty, before you play Crisis Core, you should replay Final Fantasies 1 through 15, including the spinoffs. Don't tempt me with a good time.
No, not another flying fucker. Luke's gonna be like, why did you use lightning on this guy? And it's like, because he's an asshole who won't just let me kill him correctly. Just chop your feet off, please.
Ice is asking when Sea of Thieves starts. It's 2.5 hours from now, so 3:30 Central.
Can you saber throw with this one? I didn't even know you could throw this sword.
Yeah, people have been screaming saber throw.
What's the button for that?
Chanting.
Oh, I clicked L earlier and it didn't give me the single blade.
Oh, it's better if you have a controller, so maybe you should switch controller.
No. Chain stance. Oh, did I have to? Okay. Duh. Okay. The reason I didn't know there was a throw is because I thought somebody said in the last stream that you could throw the double blade. Maybe you can.
That'd be chaos. I feel like you try to catch it on the way back and you just cut your body in half.
Yeah. Oh shit. Whoa, bye. I just papal teamed that guy. Uh-huh. Or I mean, Mace Windu that guy. Gone.
Unlimited power.
I'm going Anakin Skywalker on these guys now. Did that droid just run off? Yeah. Look at this droid. It's just like, I'm fucking out of there. Smart.
You won't get far. Stogie in the chat is convinced that you have a ghost in your room because they keep seeing a shadow moving around. It's either a ghost or a dog.
They see a shadow?
I don't know.
Maybe it's my curtain moving? I don't know. You just... Alright, just eat all the bullets. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Eat the bullets. Eat the bullets. Yeah, well, it could be Shadow the Hedgehog in next room.
Why aren't you a fan of Sonic?
Pull out its gun.
There's no shadow in here. You guys made me look. You're just trying to get me to look behind me.
I don't know.
Maybe it's the ghost of Barry's fart from last night.
Could be the ghost of Barry's fart from last night. Absolutely.
I went back and looked at that stream. I did not realize how red my face got. That thing was not good.
It's the lingering residue of Perry's fun.
Yeah. Where do you think you're going? Come back here. Better things to do. Here, I'm gonna help you. Bye. You guys are pulling my leg.
Think about this, Stogie. What if you are the one who has a ghost and is haunted into your monitor, so that's why you really want to see it?
Yeah.
Bro, Stogie. You got a Stogie ghost.
I thought you said a hoagie ghost for a second. I was like, that's interesting. You know what I got for Christmas that I just used yesterday that I love already?
A hoagie maker?
Well, close enough. I got a panini maker.
Oh, hell yeah. He's great.
That's also how I know I'm old, because I'm excited about a sandwich.
Sandwiches are fucking great.
All right, hate these things. Why do I only have one concussion shot? I need more.
Chin Whip and ask, is Bad Batch connected to Republic Commando? I mean, it is not. No.
Nope. Did I miss an ammo box in here? I need an ammo box. Oh, you're alive. Let's take care of that.
That I got excited about my new vacuum cleaner.
Yeah, I did too. My new vacuum cleaner is great. It gets all the dog hair up.
It's the little things in life.
Damn it. What are you just standing in lava? Oh, that grenade hit him with one hit. Okay, that's incredible. Can I do that again? I headshot him.
Fill my ass up. Thank you so much for the donation. So, is there a favorite Jedi Academy so far? I like the Shunjin Academy.
No.
Persona joke. Which of these games has been your favorite? Jedi Outcast?
Yeah, Jedi Outcast for sure. There's been like two missions in this that I really liked, but the rest of it's felt like filler. No, I don't want to be under arrest. Go away. Oh, I missed. Oh, no, you jumped straight up instead of out of the lava, you dummy. Okay. Now we can fight these guys. And if I don't miss. What? Why did they only give me two shots for that thing? Shit. Okay. Oh,
yeah,
Jesus.
Dumbly is a good point. The lava is hot. You need to be careful. I don't know if you knew that.
I have. My character reminded me of that. This lava looks almost like exactly like the lava from Dark Souls. It's impressive.
Both Izalith? Yeah. You will die by my hand. Did they maybe actually finish this level? Unlike Lost Izalith in the game? Shots. Do you still have quick save connected to screenshot?
Yes.
A couple people were wondering.
I'm documenting my whole journey. Don't worry about it.
If you're confused at why you occasionally hear the screenshot.
No, I'm not confused.
No. Chat.
Oh, chat. Was
confused. If that is confused why you're continually hearing screenshot noises, it's because the quick save button is the screenshot button. Can it be changed? Yes. Will it be changed?
Never. I think Chaz realizes now how, or understands how stubborn of a person I am when it comes to some games.
Just games, though. Definitely not everything else.
Yeah, exactly.
Definitely not everything else.
Yeah, see, you know what's up.
Yep. Okay, yeah, I saw that earlier today. The Deadpool DLC for Midnight Suns is coming out in a week. I'm curious how they're going to fold that in. If it's going to be meaty stuff, or if it's just going to be add them to your party for Spoofs and Goofs. You go on weird Deadpool dates.
Where'd that guy go? He just disappear? Oh, there you are. Come back here. You don't need your arm. Screenshot. See, chat. The reason I did the screenshot thing is because chat yells at me to save so often that they know I save if they hear the screenshot. It's like, you know,
yeah,
training a dog.
Yeah. Chat, are you the dog or is Chat the dog?
Chess a dog. they hear the save function, they know screen, or they hear the screenshot function, they know I saved. Pavlov's theory. Come down here. Stupid jetpacker.
Stupid Jack Packard.
There, bye-bye. He got what he deserved.
What's up, Frost? Welcome. I think Nick's doing great.
This is definitely, this has to be the last mission of the game. This is long.
I think people were saying that this last chapter is very long. Like the missions drag on longer than
one more. Last of two missions, okay. Usually that last mission in those short chapters is just a boss fight. I got three boss fights. Yay. Who's that? Who are you? You look fancy. I have a solution to this. Bye-bye. That's never not satisfying. Just a very difficult looking guy. Oh, push off the ledge. Bye-bye. She has a gun, that's not fair. Oh, she missed.
Jedi's got a gun.
So, the itty-bitty Jedi has come to rescue his friend. That's so sweet.
Where's Rosh?
What makes you think he wants to be rescued? Tavion turned him to the dark side. Just like that.
Where is he?
Ooh, someone's getting awfully angry, aren't they?
Seductionist over here.
Look, Aurora.
Oh no, we get three boss fights. That's too many boss fights. To join us and fight her. They need
I am taking Rosh out of
need to figure out what's going on there.
Take it easy on yourself and tell me where he is.
He's around. I think I'll go look for him.
Take my little itty bitty Jedi, go kick some ass. Let's see. Wow, did I lose health because he fell on my head? Did you hear something? Yeah, there's a lightsaber behind you, bro.
Frost, is there a game that has a boss where they can beat you with the literal health bar? I want to play that game, otherwise I guess I have to make it. Seems like something that should have been made, where someone starts pulling UI elements and beating the shit out of you with it.
Oh, he just one-shot me. That's not nice. No, the game crashed. Okay. Coming back. I really can't. I know like a bunch of people said they love this game for the multiplayer. I cannot imagine playing this game in multiplayer. I feel like it would just be a lot of flinging shit around.
Yeah. Good thing you have a recent screenshot to load from.
Hell
don't
yeah.
You worry. Oh, Milky says apparently Deadpool has that as a special move in Marvel vs. Capcom 3. He literally pulls down the health bar and beats the enemy with it.
That's awesome.
Hey, me burning Abos. Sorry, Frost. It already happened.
Oh, I was trying to do the special move and I kicked instead.
That does sound like a Suda idea, Jumbly. I imagine Suda's probably used that in some game.
Another screenshot. The library's full of dumb looking screenshots. Thank you. Gotcha. And not that door. And this door. Screenshot.
We're also strongly suggesting that you bind force push to a button. For the next level, because apparently there's going to be a lot of force push in the next level.
What? The game does that like slow animation when you kill somebody, like slows the game down, but it doesn't slow them down. Still, yeah, they still attack you, and so sometimes you
there's
just
like no
die.
Iframes in that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh yeah, this looks cool. By the way, have fun dying.
They did Frost, mostly because I just didn't want Tom Brady to win, because at a certain point, I don't want successful people to still be successful. I think everyone needs to be taken down a peg, so I'm always glad to see him taken down a peg.
Oh god damn it, I keep forgetting. I forgot from last stream too, the red light is when they have the rage going.
Oops. Oh, it's not good.
Yep.
Thanks for watching, Stogie. We'll see you later. Have a good rest of your day.
Stuff over here, yes it is. And shield booster? Nope. Okay.
John Blue says these are the pools that Evil Sith jazzercise in. I can see that.
Jazzercise?
Yeah. Exercise in the music. Jazzercise.
Oh. How?
That's a new funding goal, is Nick Jazzercises.
Nope. Okay.
Are all Jedi as weak as Rosh, or just?
Well, Hunter says anyone still playing Elden Ring? I feel like it was the most important thing in the world for a while, and then everyone stopped. Not like Dark Souls, where people keep replaying for years. I think that's a little skewed. I think like Elden Ring was still the center of conversation for what felt like the entirety of last year.
Elden Ring's also a huge open world game. It's a commitment to really play that one all the way through again.
Yeah.
Unless you're Jack.
Yeah.
Not many people are like Jack.
Also, you're thinking about that as Dark Souls. Come get me, Jedi. You're looking at Dark Souls 12 years later, where people will revisit it. I think Elden Ring will still be a game people revisit. But like in 2014 and stuff like that, 2015, I don't know how many people were playing Dark Souls 1. There you go. Elden Ring has 65,000 people playing it right now.
Well,
I think Elden Ring is still massively popular.
Yes, I can't wait for them to add some expansions to it.
Oh my god, Beast Marsh still playing. I'm at 691 hours so far.
Damn.
I love it. I love it mostly because when Beast Marsh would beat specific bosses, then he would send donations and super chats and it follows. So.
Yeah.
We would benefit from it, which I was a big fan of.
Yeah, I haven't had a game since Elden Ring that has enthralled me as much as Elden Ring. you. Ow. Oh, quit that.
These much, I believe. I believe you'll be able to beat Melania.
Yeah, I think my time of getting to beat her is long gone. So I haven't played that game in months now. I'm like, you know, it's gonna take me like a year just to reorient myself with the game to do it.
Slicky-san, Elden Ring is literally a Dark Souls 3 mod. The state of the AAA industry is crapola. What a boring take. It's a real boring take, Slicky-san.
A dark... that's not even a boring take. That's just a dumb take.
Also, it's fine if you don't enjoy stuff, but you also just let other people enjoy stuff. It's very easy.
That's the one part of media coverage that I hate, is like, I can't just enjoy something without somebody telling me I'm dumb for enjoying
it. Yeah, Dark Souls 3 does rule, John. It's really good. God, also the Ring City DLC? Oh. What a pick.
Oh, don't. The floatiness does not help me sometimes.
Yeah, Duke of Doom. I think Dark Souls 2 got a bit of a reevaluation, like so many things do. I think people see that it's a bit of a shaggy mess, but what is there is pretty damn great, and some ideas that I would love to see them revisit. Lamp you with a highlight. Lamp, I don't know why you bring this up. We've had such a nice 90 minutes not talking about Halo. You know it's real crapola, the Halo franchise for the last 15 years.
Ooh.
That's not true. When did Halo 3 come out? 2007? 2008?
2007.
Okay. ODST was cool.
Yeah. Halo Reach was great, too.
Halo Reach was good, too.
Halo Reach is my favorite one. But like I've always said, Halo stands like on another pole for me just because I love the music of those games so much. Mm-hmm. Like if I hear the music, I want to replay the game. No other game does that for me. Besides maybe Uncharted 3 soundtrack too.
Oh, nice.
Don't tell me I can't get back up there because I jumped down here. Come on, force jump, power up. No! Ugh, this is dumb. Let me get out of here. I don't know where I'm going.
Apparently there's a tunnel. Is there a shiny red bullet?
Is there up or down?
No, it's just tunnel. Some direction.
Maybe it was on the ground. Sometimes it's so hard to see with the textures.
Nikoi says down.
Oh god.
Okay. Last level down.
Oh, there is a little tunnel. Nope, that's a secret. Okay. Oops. Tunnel.
Porch Lucas, hot steam blocking the player. Classic game design. Love when the hot steam. You remember how many times in my life hot steam gets in the way and I'm like, shit, how do I get around this hot steam?
No, not that far down.
No, not that far down. You went too far down.
Tunnel. Ow. Found you. Oh, we forgot to have our conversation that we were going to start the stream with. Chat, I need to know, what is your... Wait, this problem's dead. Okay, I'm in the new area. Chat, what is your definition of clickbait?
Oh, yeah.
I really want
to... I forgot that that's what we were going to talk about when we started. Yeah. And we just started arguing about Halo. Yeah.
No! Oh, God damn it! Fell. They got my stomach. Bait to make you click. Well, okay.
David, I'm putting you in the void. Lampy. I agree with Lampy's. I personally agree with Lampy's definition. Clickbait is where the title of the article is unrelated to the contents and is therefore just there to get someone to click.
So, not content that you just disagree with, right?
I think, yeah, people, the people who equate an opinion they disagree with as clickbait seems genuinely insane to me. Like, we put up a op-ed on the site by Colin Munch, one of our new writers, a great writer, about The Last of Us, the first episode of The Last of Us show, and it is HBO's The Last of Us ironically lacks the cinematic storytelling of the game. And he talks about why he was kind of underwhelmed by the first episode because he thinks it did things in a less cinematic way than the game did. And the entire article is that. And then people are like, that's clickbait. I'm like, no, it's just an opinion you disagree with. The headline of the article is literally what the article is about. It is like, and the image on the article is of The Last of Us show. So it's like, yeah. Just genuinely crazy.
It's legit, like legitimately impressive how people just, and I don't know, it just gets so mad about opinions that they don't agree with on movies and TV and games. It's just incredible.
Insanity.
I've been doing this for so long, like you think eventually some people like grow up. It's not the case.
Yep. Just Frost said, I disagreed with the take, but I liked the read, and he talked the title. Exactly, me too. That is exactly my thing. I like publishing takes I disagree with if they're well. If you back up, you know what you're saying, it's great. I think it's genuinely not so. Chain whip, and it's not technically clickbait, but you could argue it's a hot take just for clicks. But you can't argue that. Like that's just that feels like something people say. Like Colin doesn't have any.
Would any? I mean, if that's the logic you're gonna take with it, then any opinion you disagree with is a hot take generated for clicks.
Yeah.
I mean, like, a hot take generated clicks is like saying, I don't know, just Elden Ring is the worst game of all time. That's a hot clue. That's a hot take, yeah. And that's just made for clicks. Still somebody's opinion, but, I mean, just not a whole lot you could probably back that up with.
Yeah.
Especially when, like, games like Carnivores and this. I get so. That's like Colin was like the writer. It's kind of sad, like the state of things, because like the writer of that piece was like, I'm worried I'm gonna get doxxed over this piece. I was like, no.
Doxxed? Just get a bunch of dummies in the menchies.
Oh, crunching me. What the fuck just happened? Am I even supposed to be here? Where am I going? Okay, I'm supposed to be here. Oh shit! I almost got crunched. I don't want to get crunched. We'll run from that. Oh, I got crunched. What the hell? This might be. I'm sure I'm missing something easy again, but that's fine. Okay, would you stop, goddamn force pushing guy? He's just pushing me in the corner and killing me. This is. I just got ganked. Single player game. I just got ganked. Oh, he's doing it again. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna force light your ass. Here. Enjoy that. Enjoy the conveyor belt. Bye bye. I don't. You're stuck down there. You can't do anything anymore.
This section seems like a mess. Nice.
Ah, there is a thing there that crunched him. Crunch? No! Can I survive here? No, I can't. Yes, I can. Oh god! Okay. Oh, it's squishing me. Oh, now they're shooting at me trying to get through here. This is bad. I don't like this at all. Oh my god, everything's crunching me. Speed. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting that speed slows down time too. So I don't use it. What do you think is?
I don't know.
This is the worst.
Oh, stop! Stop it! Stop it! I can't get out of there.
God.
Andrew Hickam, the problem is you're wrong, because the Polygon article about The Last of Us had the greatest video game story ever told in quotes, because it was referencing quotes from Craig Mazin saying that, and so it was talking about the game as a whole. Also, saying something is the best video game story game, or the best video game story ever, can't be wrong, because it's purely an opinion. So if someone says, I think The Last of Us is the best video game story ever, that's not wrong, that's their opinion.
Oh my god, go away, this guy.
Yeah, Andrew, you didn't read the article and you got angry at it. That's just as bad as clickbait.
Yeah.
That's worse than clickbait.
You are the problem, literally.
Yeah. For shame. You were the chosen one, Andrew. You're supposed to destroy the Sith, not join them.
Oh yes, Chad, I was rushing there. This part's frustrating me, so I'm just throwing myself into it for a second. I don't feel like using the speed thing is gonna help me here. Maybe it will, I don't know. But like, there's just nowhere to go in this second part.
George Lucas says this is harder than the last level of Crash 4.
I could keep getting stuck on the level geometry, and it's annoying. It's very annoying. Don't smash me, you fucker. You smashed me.
I thought we all agreed Asura's Wrath is the greatest video game story. I have that. I bought that on very cheap on Xbox recently, and I definitely want to. I'll fill my ass up, says you're supposed to go above it. The second one.
Oh yeah, no, I know that. The problem is the second part, like there's just nowhere to go. Cause I can't crouch underneath it, and then it's gonna kill me as soon as it goes down. Ugh.
Stop, I'm stuck again. Fuck.
Stop. No, I'm stuck. Okay, I made it. Rip. I'm alive. I didn't die yet.
Don't know.
Fuck. I hate this. I hate this very much right now. Piecing it together and piecing where I gotta go to make it. Okay, I think I can hide here.
Stay in the rafters. This is where I die. This is where I live from now on.
And that killed me. Okay. You get stuck on so many things. If you don't go exactly where you like the game wants you to go, you're getting stuck. And their jump is just a little bit too floaty for this part.
Domo says, the last two, Nick, you have to run on the side of.
There, I got it. What is happening? Why is this? I feel so weird. Okay, there we go. Ah, shit. I don't want to deal with you. I'm just leaving. I'm fucking out of here.
Perhaps you too will learn to serve Tavion.
Guys, I missed the conveyor belts.
I don't.
Just thinking about conveyor belts.
Where'd this second guy? Is that the guy I didn't kill earlier and he came back? God damn it. He's like, I'm not done with you. Oh no, he's got the rage stuff. Get away. There we go. Nico Nemo, that's just mean. You shouldn't wish that on me.
Well, everyone just
what
missed,
I do deserve this.
Everyone missed hearing the screenshot noise.
Yeah.
percent Donkey Prank, don't worry, Marty. There's a section in Half-Life that's all about conveyor belts. Well, that's a KC worry. That's not a me worry.
Yeah.
You also asked earlier what our Half-Life, how we're gonna play Half-Life. I don't know. I thought Black Mesa would just be the easiest way because it's the most modern way to play Half-Life. And then Yahtzee got his knickers in a twist, as they say. And then we're saying we need to play the original, which seems kind of silly to me. Just play whatever's the most playable thing. But I don't know. And then people were talking about texture packs. I don't know what the fuck's going on there. Casey and I are button boys. We don't want to have to deal with all this nonsense.
No? No more conveyor belt for me? Oh, there it is. Get up there.
Oh, no.
Momentum game. There's such a thing as momentum. God. Pro tip, Marty, don't jump on the thing because momentum does not exist in this game.
No more monkeys jumping on the
too early for those kind of physics.
Rosh!
Jaden!
You don't look like much of a captive, Rosh. Did you dream this up or was it Tavion's idea?
No, Jaden, wait!
See, this is the problem. Wrong. I brought it up. Please. And literally every comment is a different suggestion for what we should do.
Jaden.
Can't
back.
Play the original Half-Life unless please you have a 3D FX voodoo card strapped to a Riva TNT.
You tried to kill me,
like that.
And now you've lured me into a trap.
Jaden?
As long as the original... Like, I'm fine playing the original as long as it's fine to stream. Because I don't want to get into one of those situations where we try to load it up on stream and it's just being a fucking... A doof. No more games being doofs.
How do I know you won't betray me again? You're always trying to beat me. How do I know this isn't just another trick?
Jaden, don't do it.
Finish him, Jedi.
Ooh.
Wait! Listen to what you're saying. You're angry. Don't give in to it.
Dark side time?
That leads to the dark side, right?
Shocking that Nick is gonna go to the dark side.
He only fell to the dark side because he was scared, afraid of dying. Put away your saber.
Strike him down. Give in to your anger.
Jaden, you're better than that. Don't give in to your anger. Rosh is telling the truth.
Much Lampy says, ears, 20 pounds to play Black Mesa, ignore Yahtzee, and lock him in the Burger again. Just play the best version of the game that's available. But Jombly over here is saying that the AI in Black Mesa is incredibly accurate and unfair. So I also don't like that.
Jaden, no! Let go of your anger!
Why should I? You yourself said how powerful the dark side was.
I
turned
wrong.
Him into bacon.
No. You were weak.
Jaden, no!
Ooh.
Well done, Jedi. You have become one of us. Now, join us. With Mark Aragnos as our master, we will defeat the Jedi and rule the galaxy. Join
no, Speakeasy, I don't think he's going to become more powerful. I think he's dead.
The scepter of Ragnos is too powerful to be left in the hands of someone as weak as Tavion. If anything, it should belong to me.
Oh, you think so?
You, on the other hand, are no use to me. I should have killed you on Hoth. You won't get us.
100% Donkey Princess. That was cold.
Jesus Christ, I just, hate Rosh, but that was cold.
I just wanted to do the opposite of what people expected. Well, okay. From the game, not me. People knew I was going to do that.
Did not subvert any of my expectations there.
Yeah. I just wanted to see what the dark side would end up leading to.
Apparently the last mission is now going to be more difficult because of the decision you made.
Sweet. I've beaten Elden Ring and Dark Souls, and I'm fine.
You haven't beat Dark Souls 2.
Oh, you threw me into the lava, you jerk!
Did you know the lava was hot?
Did. Because she told me. Oh, I'm dead again. Okay, now you can't come behind me and kill me later, so I took care of you. Okay, I can't believe I didn't save when I was doing this the first time, but here we are. Come on. There we go. Yeah. Okay, we saw you die before. No way, you have to do it again.
You won't get away, coward.
Hi, dogs. Can I help you? Please don't fire it again, Barry.
Oh no, were those the ghosts? The ghosts that we got to catch today against you? I miss Ghost Guy. We think Ghost Guy's a thing.
You miss Ghost Guy?
And the guy kept seeing ghosts.
Oh, yeah,
I'm worried
go?
That he has, like, cataracts or something. I don't know, he kept saying stuff, and then he said, no one's talking to me, so I'm gonna leave. And then I said, bye. He's just kept talking about ghosts. I don't know, I don't have that many things to say about the ghosts that aren't there. I don't know.
What? How's he not dead?
Kyle?
Rosh.
That was a run.
I'm sorry. Jaden has turned. You've lost both your students.
Don't worry, I'm going to keep Nick Rumbles. I promise I'll keep doing the Star Wars games when we're not playing Star Wars games.
Thank you.
Oh, now Roth is dead.
Damn. Rips.
But I still lost Jaden. Where did she go? I've got to get to Korriban.
Do I get this? Ooh, I wonder. Am I the final boss? Do I get to switch
to
Kyle and destroy my Padawan? No, the game crashed again. Shit. Why? Stop that.
Marty, what's your favorite Star Wars robot and why is it HK-47? HK-47 is incredible. My favorite recent Star Wars robot, B2 Emo in Andor. What a cute little stuttering sad boy. I loved him. Data the Port thinks that Kyle Katarn looks a little bit like Jemaine. I can see that.
Jaden, what happened to-
Out of my way. The scepter will be mine.
Oh no. I sense the dark side in you, Jaden. I can't let you pass.
I will pass, whether you want me to or not.
Ooh, now I'm gonna kill a Jedi? Alright. We'll go full Anakin here.
Kill little Grogu.
Please surrender. Come get
me. Speaking of these HK-47, KOTOR's best character. I haven't played either KOTOR game in a long time. Like, probably 18 years. HK is one of the few characters I actually still remember. I am excited to do. I want to replay KOTOR to refresh my memory.
It's on my list to do for my backlog this year. Probably not on stream, just because I want to be able to actually immerse myself in the game.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think it's the best streamy. Gosh, this got the KOTOR before the KOTOR remake comes out. Well, good news,
well, long time to do that.
With the dark side path in this level, you have to fight both Sith and Jedi, whereas if you were
Jedi, you just fight the Sith.
Path, the Jedi would be your allies. You know? I feel like the Sith should be your allies in this. What's going on? We should all just be like same team.
Well, I told them. I'm not on anybody's side.
Why do I get out of this room?
I like that you can make that choice at the end, just go bad.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of games just don't let you do that kind of thing anymore. Why can't I have multicolored lightsabers? Puzzle room, yes it is.
Puzzles. Oh, if you do twin blades, you can get two separate colors, apparently.
Okay, there is a pattern to this. Is it on the floor, what I gotta do? Let's see. Okay, nothing else up here. Ouch. A little fire hurt me.
A little fire. Lampy with another 10 pounds. Thank you so much, Lampy. This is always a problem in these old Star Wars games. They always presume you're good until one point, and then you're just bad, regardless of what you've done earlier in the game. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of... That's kind of a problem with games that just have a binary choice near the end, is like, it doesn't feel fluid with what you've actually been doing throughout the entire game. I don't think anyone's really taking the story in this too seriously, though.
Oh wow, I just got murdered by
I don't know. Alright, your Hiccup Bottom said, do you change visually now that you're evil? Glowy eyes, cooler outfits, scars and shit. I don't think so. Have you changed visually at all?
Nope.
Wouldn't that be awesome? Sometimes you can't see the evil inside people. You will not prevail.
Killing a lot of Jedi here. Dang. Actually, they're killing me, but yeah, close enough.
Well, you got a lot to catch up on now that you're evil. My loot crates.
You were yelling about loot crates?
No, because we were talking about how you don't change cosmetically at all.
Oh yeah.
Gombly said, "But my loot crates."
Damn. Force is that strong with you because you're dead now.
Rippers. So what's going on? It's 2 o'clock. Are we? What's happening with the rest of this game?
Well, we're trying to get that scepter now. That's all powerful.
I don't give a shit story wise what's happening with the rest of the game. I mean, are we still streaming? Because I got 1,500 hours of streaming.
Oh, it's 2 o'clock. Yes, we will stop. Right there. I just finished that boss battle S thing. So we'll stop there and we'll finish it next week and start Republic Commando.
Look at that. A little twofer.
Because we got to stream at 3:30.
Get the end of one game and the beginning of another game.
Yes.
Perfect.
All right.
Oh, that won't be next week, actually.
Oh, yeah. I guess it'll be back in 2 weeks.
Yeah. We got other plans for streaming next week. You'll hear from that in the future.
All right. Well, thanks, everybody, for coming by and watching the latest retro Star Wars stream. We'll wrap that up today, and we'll come back in 2 weeks and wrap that up, because we have a sponsored thing to do next week. And then, come back in an hour and a half for Sea of Thieves with myself, Marty, Yahtzee, and Jack.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, you'll have Marty again from Metal Gear Rising Revengeance.
I'm going to do outfit changes every time.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to be honest, I'm probably just going to be wearing the shirt the whole time.
And then tomorrow, Amy and I will be back to wrap up Halo Infinite.
Gregorian Chance.
Yes. So,
be very exciting.
Thanks for all the super chats. Thanks for joining Patreon if you did. And thanks for hanging out. Thanks for being cool.
The wonderful conversation, everybody. You guys were great.
And we will see you all back here in an hour and a half. Bye.
Bye, everyone.